So there are certain illnesses which are pretty peculiar to monsoons, and I think we need to watch out for those illnesses. So I'll just mention a few. So with the onset of monsoon, we start seeing increasing cases of influenza, which is caused by a virus, and there are a lot of other respiratory illnesses like bacterial infections which cause pneumonias. There are increased infections in people who have asthma and bronchitis, so these are things we need to watch out for. As regards the gastrointestinal infections, we have diarrheas, dysentery, sometimes things as severe as cholera, wherein, you know, people get a lot of loose motions, dehydration. So that's one thing to worry for. Then we have foodborne infections like typhoid, hepatitis, that is predominantly known as jaundice in common terms, which can be hepatitis A or E, and these come out of eating contaminated food, so which also we need to watch out for. And lastly, we should not forget malaria, dengue, leptospirosis, which are vector-borne infections. So these things that we see very commonly in monsoons, and we need to watch out for it. So the reason why we worry about people walking through flooded water is that many times this stagnant water gets contaminated because of urine of rodents, or it can be urine of dogs, rats, etc. And we have a serious infection which is called as leptospirosis, which can be acquired by this contamination. And this leptospirosis might just present as fever with a lot of muscle ache, but it can be a very, very serious infection which can affect the heart, the lungs, the muscular system, brain. So we need to watch out for this. And in people who have walked through the stagnant water, we usually advise a prophylactic drug, which is fortunately available, but of course it has to be taken under the instruction of the doctor. And also sometimes, you know, you can get aggravation of your skin conditions, you can get fungal infections because of moisture, and if a person has a wound or an open cut in the leg, it can get infected, and that also needs to be watched for. So we in the Department of Internal Medicine, we are very experienced at handling monsoon related illnesses and tropical infections, and we have inpatient and the outpatient facility for handling these patients. Also, we have a 24-hour accident and emergency department where the patients can walk in at any time and at least get their problems starting to be solved. We have facility for 24-hour radiology and microbiology and laboratory facilities, because these illnesses, you know, they have very similar symptoms and they need to be diagnosed very well for us to, you know, give the appropriate treatment. And we have good laboratory and radiology backup, so we can offer them help. And to say the least, that if there is some complication, because these illnesses sometimes do run a complicated course, we have a host of subspecialties like chest medicine, hepatology, etc., who can back up, and, you know, we can get support from them. And also we have an intensive care unit where if the patient gets serious, he can be managed there. So if the person has got wet in the rains, at the first opportunity, he should clean, he should clean himself with fresh water, ensure that all the wet clothes are changed, and if he should carefully look at the legs for any open cuts, wounds, and ensure that it's cleaned well and an antiseptic cream is applied. And of course, think about taking doxycycline, which is a prophylactic medication, with the advice of the doctor. And another thing I just would want to point out is that when such a thing happens, and if a patient develops a febrile illness, you know, for a few days maybe home remedies are good, but if things are not coming around, then they should seek advice of doctors, because sometimes these illnesses can turn very nasty, and especially if the patient reaches late to the hospital, there is little that can be offered to them if they are in a very serious state. So I think it is important, and especially for people who are very elderly, who have other associated medical conditions like diabetes, kidney disease, heart disease, or pregnant women, should immediately seek medical attention so that these questions are answered. So especially in monsoon, it is important that we have access to clean water and clean food, and we should try and avoid eating outside as far as possible, preferably drink boiled water. we should ensure that in our surroundings there is no stagnant water or, you know, areas where water logging is there, because this can cause a breeding ground for mosquitoes, and, you know, we can fall prey to illnesses like malaria and dengue. And of course, you know, we should maintain personal hygiene, like using our hands to cover our cough, washing hands frequently so that there is less contamination, take care of the food and the water that we have. And of course, as I previously said, we should seek immediate medical attention if there are some problems.